today's topic is inflorescence. Then question arises, what is inflorescence? See, here one inflorescence is in front of you. Inflorescence, it is mode of arrangement of flower on the axis, or flowers are produced on axis, floral axis, in definite manner. It is called as inflorescence. Inflorescence has two part. This is the axis. It is called as peduncle, and these are flower. They are produced in definite manner. Then what are significances of inflorescence? First, there is grouping of flower, so chances of pollination increases. Means in single visit, insect can pollinate many flower. Then flowering period, it also increases. So naturally, chances of pollination increases. Then it makes the plant attractive, and insect, they are attracted towards the plant, and easily pollination occur. And if flowers are small, then it make flower conspicuous by grouping them. Two types of inflorescence are there. First one is raceme and second one is cymose. Here, in case of tuberose, there is a raceme type of inflorescence. Raceme means, here apex, it is not utilized in the flower formation. Means this growth of inflorescence axis, it is indefinite. Older flowers at base, younger towards the apex. This mode of arrangement of flower, it is called as acropetal or centripetal, means older at base, younger towards the apex. Again we revise, growth of inflorescence axis is indefinite. Older flower at base, younger toward apex. Apex is not utilized in flower formation, so growth of inflorescence axis is indefinite. And this is the tuberose plant. Tuberose, in Marathi we called it as a Nishigandha. And these are night blooming flower. And these night blooming flower, they are scented and they are white in color, so they are easily noticed by insect. Let's see second type of inflorescence, that is the cymose. Here, in case of rose, there is a cymose inflorescence. See here, apex, it is utilized in flower formation. Then older flower at apex, younger towards base. This is called as basipetal succession. Growth of inflorescence axis, it is definite. In case of raceme, growth of inflorescence axis is indefinite, but here the growth of inflorescence axis is definite. See, this is the older flower and these are the younger flower. And order of opening is centrifugal. Here the order of opening is centripetal. These are differences between these two inflorescences. See, first growth of inflorescence axis here indefinite. Here it is definite. Why it is definite? Because apex is utilized here in for flower formation. But in tuberose, it is not utilized in flower formation, so growth is indefinite. Second difference, order of opening of flower, here it is centripetal, means towards center. First basal flower open, then upper. Here order of opening is centripetal, means from center to periphery. First this central flower open, then this lateral one. Or older at apex, younger towards the base. See, these are the younger flowers, means birds are younger one, and this is older one, older at apex, younger towards base. Here, older at base, younger towards apex. This is called as acropetal or centripetal. Here it is called as centripetal succession. So this is the inflorescence. Inflorescence axis is called as peduncle, and flowers, these are the parts of inflorescence. And here it is spike type of inflorescence. In racemes there is basic racemes again consist different types of inflorescence. Here this is spike, means flowers, they are without stalk. See, flowers without stalk. This is cymose inflorescence. Thank you, friends. Let's revise the topic inflorescence and its type. What is inflorescence? The pattern of arrangement of flower on the floral axis, it is called as inflorescence. Here, see, this is the inflorescence axis on which this flower they are arranged. Then in inflorescence, one or more flower may be present. For example, if one flower is present, that inflorescence is called as solitary inflorescence. Then which are parts of inflorescence? First important, that is flowers. And then stalk of inflorescence, it is called as peduncle. Remember this. Stalk of inflorescence is called as peduncle, and stalk of flower is called as pedicel. Then types of inflorescence. How many types are there? Two types. Racemose and cymose. See here, racemose inflorescence is shown, which I already explained you. Growth of inflorescence axis is indefinite, as apex is not utilized in flower formation. Older flower at base, younger towards the apex. Then in cymose inflorescence, which is definite inflorescence, means growth is definite. Older flower at apex, younger towards the base. See here, older at apex and younger towards the base. That is the basipetal succession. Here again, these inflorescence type, they are explained in detail. Racemose, which is also called as indefinite or indeterminate type of inflorescence. Why these two words they are used? Because the growth of inflorescence axis is indefinite. Then acropetal succession means younger flowers at tip and older at the base. This arrangement is called as centripetal. Means, see here, order of opening is like this, means from periphery to center, hence it is called as centripetal. Then growth is indefinite. Then cymose or definite or determinate type of inflorescence, means growth of inflorescence axis is limited, as apex is utilized in the flower formation. See here, lateral axis also terminate in flower, that limits the growth of axis. Then older flower at the apex of the inflorescence axis. Then basipetal succession, older at apex or terminal end and younger at the base. This arrangement is called as centrifugal, and succession is called as basipetal succession. Centrifugal, let's see here, means from center to periphery, called as centrifugal. And older at apex, younger towards the base, this is called as basipetal succession. Again, same diagram is shown here. See, study the topics of biology by utilizing the diagram, which makes biology very easy. Read the topic by observing the diagram or specimen which are available in the surrounding, if available. Just in this video, at the starting, I explain the inflorescence by specimen. and that make the topic easy and you will score more in biology at any exam, means maybe board or your competitive exam. Competitive exam, they are not different from the board exam. So conceptual study is very important. Do not recite anything. See, here difference is explained, which already explained in the starting of my video. So just revise differences from this again. Main axis terminate in flower, so growth is definite, where cymose. In case of racemose, main axis it is, or terminal end, it is not utilized in flower formation, so growth is indefinite. Next, peduncle shows sympodial or multipodial growth, means many branches are there. Here monopodial growth. Peduncle means stalk of inflorescence. Then flowers are present in basipetal succession. Here flowers are present in acropetal succession. Arrangement of flowers, centrifugal in cymose and centripetal in racemose. The grouping of flower is more common. Here it is less common. Then in case of cymose, first flower form at the tip. In case of racemose, first flower form at the base of the peduncle. The number of flower is definite. Here the number of flower is indefinite or unrestricted. Flower bloom at a long interval, flowers bloom at a short interval. Then newly formed fruits are protected by flower, newly formed fruits are not protected by flower. Then examples of racemose inflorescence, gulmohar, that is Delonyx regia, then brassica, that is mustard. Then example of cymose inflorescence, lily, China rose and jasmine. See here, which are these type of inflorescence? Very simple, racemose, as apex is not utilized in the flower formation, so it is indefinite type of inflorescence. Thank you, friends.